away to get back home. Once was away to get back home. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Cold and slumbers fill your eyes, smiles awakes and you ride. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Get back home. Once was away to get back home. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Boy, you're gonna carry that weight. Carry that weight a long time. Boy, you're gonna carry that weight. Carry that weight a long time. And so on. Well, hi there, pluckers. I have a Sore Fingers again with another classic lesson from the Beatles, the trilogy of songs. Cold Slumbers, Carry That Weight, and The End, okay, from the Abbey Road album. Okay, so I shall be splitting this up into two or possibly three lessons. In this lesson, we're doing Golden Slumbers going into Carry That Weight. Second lesson will be Carry That Weight going into The End. And the final lesson will be probably obviously on The End. Okay, so we are doing it in the same key as it is on the original album, okay, the Abbey Road album. Standard tuning, no capos, okay. So this is my arrangement for a single acoustic guitar, okay. Singing is for reference only, okay. Don't worry about the singing. Okay, so we're starting off with an A minor 7th. Simple A minor chord, but you add your pinky to the top E string on the 3rd fret, okay. Okay, so obviously this is piano based, heavily piano based on the original track. So we're trying to imitate the piano to a large extent. I am anyway. So what we're doing is we're doing a strum and then a bass note. Okay, to get the basic feel of the piano. Okay, so it's like that sort of thing. Okay, so it's strumming down from 4 to about 1, and then hitting the 5th string open, and then repeat the strum, bass note, strum, bass note, okay? And that's how it goes, okay? So it's, okay? And that's, we do that for about 4 beats, and then we're into the song and the verse, okay? So it's, here we go then. What's all the way? Okay, so what we're doing there is A minor 7th. Into a D minor. And it's the same idea with the D minor. You strum the D minor and then hit the 4th string open. And then strum, bass note, strum, bass note. And you do that twice, okay? And then what we do is we move these two fingers on the top two strings, the first string and the second string, if you're holding a D minor like I am, up 2 frets to the 3rd fret on the top E string and the 5th fret on the 2nd string. And the idea is you hit those two strings together and hit the 4th string open. Ideally, if you want to If you hit the third string open, it doesn't sound too bad, but ideally you try and avoid it. So you can either try and just be very accurate with your plucking, or you can rest this finger on the third string. Just rest it, don't push it down, just rest on it so it mutes it. So if you hit it by accident, it doesn't sound. Okay, so that's another way you can get over that. Or just be as accurate as you can. If you do hit the third string, it's not the end of the world, okay? So that's the first bit. So it's two on the D minor. Then you move up to here, two of those. Then you move up to there. So this time my third finger is going up to the sixth fret on the second string, and my second finger is taking over on the top E string on the fifth fret. Same idea, you hit those two notes together, open fourth. Again, if you want to put that rest that finger on the third string to dampen it, you can. Or just try and be accurate, okay? So we've got this. Okay, so you've done that, you got that far. So two on that one, two on this one, two on this one. And then you hit those two, hit the fourth string, and then down to that one. So just one time, just once. Okay? Okay, so now we've got this. Then what we do is you go to a G7. Simple G7, first finger, top E string, first fret, G7. Okay, and again the idea is strum the first four strings or so, and then you hit the root note, third on the six. Okay, so it comes out of that tone. On to the way. Get back, C, home, E7, that's an E chord with the third finger off, open fourth string, second on the fifth, first on the third. So it's home, E7, sleep pretty, A minor, darling. And then do not, you put your third pinky on the third fret of the bottom E string. Just a single note, not a chord, just a single note. Do not. So it's home, sleep pretty darling, do not cry. There's this lovely little chord, a D minor ninth, or D minor nine. And that is open fifth string. I'm not playing the bottom E string on this chord, okay? Fifth string open. Second finger is playing the third fret of the fourth string, the D string. First finger is playing the second on the third. And the third finger is playing the third fret of the second. And the top E string is open. So, should sound like that, okay? And the way I play it is on this particular chorusy bit, I just do one single strum. Let it ring. Just nice. So, from the beginning. Once there was a way to get back home. Once there was a way to get back home. Sleep pretty, darling, do not cry. And then what we do is there's a pause, five, two, three, four, a G7 strum all the way through, and then I will sing. So you have to get into this. This is a rather strange time, but it's G7, and I will sing, and then you go double pluck, second fret, third string, first fret, second string. Okay, just those two strings. I'm plucking. You can either just do it as a double pluck, double sort of double stop like that, or you can pluck it third string with your pick, second string with your finger like that, or you can just do the two together with a pick. Okay, so G7, and I will sing, and then you move that up two frets, these two fingers up two frets. First finger is now on the third fret of the second string, and the second finger is on the fourth fret of the third. Just those two notes. Okay, so and I will sing G7 again, lullaby, and then you go back to this strum bass note on the C chord, C strum root note, third on the fifth there. Okay, and then we're going into the golden slumbers bit. Okay, so let's just go through this whole bit again. Okay, slowly. Once it was a way to get back home. Once it was a way to get back home. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. So for those dingle, 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 okay, and then we're into the chorus, C, then you can start strumming, go and slumbers, right, that's C, I'm doing a four fingered C there, just that, moving that third finger up to the third on the sixth, pinky going to the third on the fifth, so you can hit all six strings. Golden Slumbers is an F major 7. I'm playing a four-fingered F with an open top string. Lift the bar up, top E string open, 5 down to 1. Again, from a simple F, or you can play a simple one like that, just a F, straightforward F chord with the bar lifted up, open top E string open. But if you want to get a bit more depth in it, I move this third finger up to the fifth string on the third fret and put pinky on the third on the fourth, and then go from 5 down to 1, get a bit more depth into the chord, yeah? So C, oh, F major 7 for the slumbers, feel back to C, your eyes, repeat, smiles, F major 7 for awake, when you see your eyes, and then we repeat the last bit of the verse section. Sleep, E7, A minor, darling. Thumb on the third on the sixth. Don't you, this D minor ninth. And this time I do, and that's a strum, and then hitting the A string, the fifth string open. And then the usual G7, and I will sing a lullaby. Okay, and you do. Do that one again, okay? So, and then basically we just got another verse to do, okay? So, go from the golden slumbers and we'll do another verse, okay? So, just repeating what we've already learnt, okay? So, golden slumbers fill your eyes, smiles awake you when you rise. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby, once a way to get back home, once a way to get back home. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. And when we stop on that one, it's the end of the song on this particular section of the song, Golden Slumbers. You just single strum on the C, bit of a pause, and then we go into Carry That Weight, okay? Boy, you've got to carry that weight. Just the two chords, okay, C to G7 or G, depending on what you like the sound of. Could be a G, could be a G7th, okay, whichever you like the sound of, okay. Boy, gotta carry that beat. Now, what happens then, after you've done two lots of carry, that boy you're going to carry that weight, you do C, a run down from C to A minor, C, C with B in the bass, the second fret of the fifth string. Hit that note with your pick, pick that note out, okay? Sort of half arpeggiate and then strum into an A minor. And then it goes, and we're into the intercarry, or into the next part of carry that weight, okay? I'll never give you my pillow, that sort of thing, okay? Which is basically an A minor. So you do the single strum on the A minor, and then basically you up-pick the A minor. And I'm doing what I'm doing there is, basically, I'm fretting the fifth fret of the third string and the second string. The top string is open, as is the fourth string, and I'm going four down to one and then to a D minor. So it's coming out of that carry that way through the whole time. Okay, and that's so I'll leave it there. And we'll come back to the rest of that song in part two. Okay, so there you have it, boys and girls. That's Gordon Slumbers and Into Carry That Weight. Okay, so I think we'll just try and go through it again, shall we? Just in its completeness, see if I can get through it again in one go. Okay, here we go. Once was the world. Get back home, sleep, baby, darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Golden slumbers fill your eyes, smiles awake when you rise. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Whistle away to get back home. Once away to get back home. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Boy, you're gonna carry that weight a long time. Boy, you're gonna carry that weight, carry that weight. Didn't quite get that, but nearly got it. Anyway, I shall see you in part two, okay? We'll carry on with Carry That Weight going into the end, okay? Bye for now.